Hey everybody, welcome to my video. This is actually a VR response to a contest that one of my friends, Zed Outdoors, is running. I'll put his link to his channel in the information down below. This is a bit of a blanket kind of review because I can't get outside right now. I'm actually had a back injury and I've been out of work for a couple of weeks, so I can't get outdoors and can't do much of anything right now. I'm still doing chiropractor stuff and stretches and all that. So you'll have to suffice. This won't be a dirt review, but a blanket review. So to start with, we'll cover the five C's or six C's, however many C's you find necessary. But with the kit I carry when I am actually sort of bushcrafting versus car camping or backpacking, this would be my essentials kit. So I'll start from the beginning. We've got a 90-10 wool blanket. That's from a canteen shop a number of years ago. We've got a couple of Malcolm Hidden Woodsman straps on there to keep the bedroll intact. This one is approximately 6 by 7.5 feet. So it's a good size blanket, a little bigger than a lot of the surplus ones. Also a little heavier. Again, from Malcolm at Hidden Woodsman. He doesn't make these anymore, but this is a digital camo tarp. This is a 5x7 with numerous tie-outs. It is a sil nylon. And actually, this one is not a sil nylon. This is a very light, I think it's a 200D Cordura that's coated with waterproofing and also fire retardant. There is a pair of inexpensive leather mitts. See, I haven't used these much, but I have certainly used them. They're basic protection when you're grabbing something out of the fire or got something sharp around, you want to keep your hands a little bit better shape. Blade number one is an Opinel. This is a carbon number 7, I think. So this one is a nice little fold-up knife. You can see it's got the guard on here where you have to fold it up, spin it, close it up, spin the lock around, and that makes it so it won't open up on purpose without a reason. I have a Mora knife. This is a discontinued one. It's an old brand one. It's a FT2060, which I think is close to what they went with the Garberg or the Bushcraft large one, the Bushcraft Black. Fairly large blade, nice edge on it, nice and sharp. I've scratched the heck out of this one with fire steels. Comes with a nice plastic scabbard, good click in there, and it's got a good thick belt loop that you can get into most belts. What else have we got here? We've got a fire kit. So there's more stuff in this little bag. This is a pouch, again, from Hidden Woodsman. There's a protected Bic lighter, your easiest fire. Some Strike Anywhere matches. See those there. Usable resource, but I've got lots of them. They're cheap right now. A fire steel. This is from Scott at Wessex Blades. It's got the leather lanyard on as well. It throws good sparks. Very good at fire starting. The rest of the fire kit is in here. There's a couple pieces of fat wood, a couple handfuls of lint, one of these magnesium with a fire starter on there. I've never found these very useful, but I carry it around just for the hell of it. Someday I'll do a video about that if I ever get motivated. And also one of the greatest tinder creators in here, and that would be pencil sharpener. This is a eBay find. It is a makeup pencil sharpener, so it has a large and a smaller outlet. Usually the larger one is bigger for twigs. You just put a twig in there, it's relatively dry. Shave off your Kindle, and there you go. You've got some fire starter. Again, this is a Cordura with a water repellent and fire retardant coating. From fire, we go to water. Another one of the Hidden Woodsman pouches. This is my blue one, this is water. You can see the little bag in there and the flushing kit. That's for the Sawyer Mini. Sawyer Mini is backed up by a number of chemicals. There's Aquamira tabs and Katadin tabs. They're both two different chemicals depending on what you're treating, if you just need to alternate between them. I believe there's enough here to treat about, I think, 25 or 30 liters of water without including the Sawyer Mini. Of course, you could always go with the Sawyer Mini first, pull that through to your water bottle, and then disinfect with one of these products, which really gets you closer to purification than anything else. Fire starter, if you want to go old school, in here is a Light My Fire fire steel, a few more water pills, and a piece of fire starter. I believe there's a couple of wet fire cubes in here. There's some inner tube on there if you need it to really get a fire started, and you can make char cloth in this tin. It's got a hole in there. Also got flint and steel. I've used those to start fires a number of times, usually just to show off, not usually because I have no other options. And something every, I'm sure, prehistoric bushcrafter would have carried if they had them available. It's the heavy cover, ultra lightweight titanium canteen with canteen lid and the canteen cup. This is my primary cooking and serving device if I was pre-war bushcrafting. This holds 1.1 liter, nests in there nicely, goes inside the pack. Reach across again. There's also the heavy cover lid, titanium, which goes on top of the canteen when you're trying to boil or trying to keep the bugs out. There's a compass. This is generic. It's the military style with the sighting line and the magnifier as well. And that's north over that way, sort of. In my building, my floor just beneath me here is reinforced with rebar, so compass readings are notorious for being off when I'm inside the house. If you want to make something like a kuksa or some spoons and such, is also the... This one is another Mora product. This is the hook knife or spoon carving blade. I've used it a few times. I haven't perfected the technique, so I don't have anything awesome to show you yet. We've got some paracord. I think that's a 100-foot hank thereof. We've got a couple of cutting tools. Now, I'm a fan of the Silky product. This is a Gomboy 240. And I'll show you the blade because, yes, they do break. This is one of the first pieces of Silky that I bought probably at least 10 years ago. I pinched it in a cut. You can see it's got a bend and the blade is broken. It still works fine since. Just got to nestle it a little bit to get it into the actual handle. Works great. Kicks the butt on some of the other brand of saws. It's got a nice carry case, although a drawback from it is it does not have a belt loop or anything on there. It only goes in one way, and that was the wrong way. Let's try it that way, and she clicks shut. Next is, this is going to be something that's going to disappear. This is not a Grants vs. Brooks. This is a Wetterlings. I'll show you the name there, Wetterlings. This I bought about 2 or 3 years ago, and since then, Wetterlings has been bought out by Grants vs. Brooks, and they will be producing Grants vs. Brooks product for Grants vs. Brooks. This one, I believe, is the Forest Axe. It's about a 20-inch handle. I put a leather wrap on there to protect it. My knot's a little bit proprietary. I didn't do it the way you're supposed to by some of the books with the inside knot and the noose type thing. It's also got a lanyard at the end to keep it on your hands when you're swinging wildly, and a nice little mask for it, which fits ever so snug. And that's most of my kit. Now what I carry then is one of the first version Malcolm's Hidden Woodsman. This is his little day pack, the haversack. This one I remember when we talked, I asked him for this D-ring, and that D-ring is put on there so I could hang my pepper spray from a carabiner. And we also discussed these two loops on the side as axe loops, which he at the time on his prototype didn't have. So this is one of my prized pieces of kit because it has evolved since what this is, and it is different now than it was. But this kit has served me well. I've used it for numerous different occasions, numerous different projects. It's been to Hawaii with me. It's been to Washington with me. It's been camping, hiking, you name it, whatever I've done. That's probably been with me as a backup somewhere, sometimes visible, sometimes not in my pictures. So that's my one take shot at my Bushman's kit for bushcrafting, if I choose to do so. I could augment this with numerous other products, but I think this really covers your bases and gets you through the night with a little bit of how-to, chop some wood, make a shelter, you'd be good to go. Thanks for your time, I appreciate it. If you enjoy the content, please like, share, and subscribe. Leave me a comment if you wish to do so, and we'll see you on the next one.